More on the manhunt for the Desert Dream Killers, who first robbed the Two Rock County Sheriff's house, then took shelter at a motel that turned into the scene of a... Describe Jay Holt as an awkward, quiet high school dropout. Holt also has an accomplice, 16-year-old Vanessa Dorland, who is assumed to be armed and dangerous. If you see either of these violent criminals, please call 911 and make...
Don't speak. Don't make a sound.
Did he take anything else?
Yes, my slippers.
Oh, give me a break. Your grandfather wandered outside in his robe for the third time this month. When he realized he didn't have his keys, he broke the door to get back in.
That is not true. I wanted some air, so I took a walk, and I saw someone, the next thing I know, I'm arguing with Shelby here.
That's not even my name.
Yeah.
Zoe, I know this is painful to hear, but your grandfather is declining. He needs a nurse or an assisted living home.
Oh, God damn it, I don't need assisted anything.
We obviously have very different interpretations of what happened. Still, somebody will have to pay for that door.
You don't need to keep badgering him. Besides, it's your word against his.
Huh. I see the apple hasn't fallen far from the tree.
I sleep fine if I take my meds.
Those go on Dr. Chowdhury prescribed.
About the only thing she was good for.
You were doing better a couple of months ago. Did something upset you back?
It doesn't matter. Seriously.
So, what else? You still doing the work?
I got fired. Missed too many shifts. I told Mom. You can imagine how that went down.
Like the Titanic he spent. Well, maybe it's a blessing in disguise. You always talked about being an investigative journalist. Why didn't you go get a degree?
I don't know, Grandpa. I just want to wake up on a beach somewhere. No one around. Walk out into the ocean. Disappear under the waves.
No, you don't. Take it when someone has been a pro at running away. Wherever you run, your problems run there for you. Hang on. Where's my tablet computer thing? Oh, no. Those bastards. I got that for my 74th.
Can I kind of grow a little? Maybe I can figure out who's doing your stuff.
Be my guest.
Books, medical books. Is this all from when you were a traveling salesman?
Salesman?
Yeah, you told me you used to. Wasn't that your job?
Yeah, back then you could say I was a jack of all trades. I think the only real job I ever had was convincing people I was someone else.
Grandpa, are you taking your meds?
I don't like them. They make me fussy.
Okay, it's your body. Grandpa, are you sure you didn't break the door yourself?
Can I be sure of something I can't remember? Have you never gone into a room, forgotten why you came in? Haven't you ever misplaced or lost something?
You know I've lost plenty. I don't want to lose you too.
Charlie's right. Someone's slowly packing red memories into boxes.
Sounds awful. I can't even begin to.
You must think I made this whole damn mess up.
Actually, someone's been following me too, I think.
What?
Earlier at the pool. And then tonight at my apartment, I thought I saw someone. But I don't know if it's even real. I feel like we're both losing our minds.
Good God. Zoe, look. I know you went through hell as a kid, losing your dad like that. And I know you sometimes think it drove you half crazy.
Seriously? You don't need to remind me.
I know I don't. But that's what I'm trying to say. I don't think you're crazy at all. Because if you were, how could we both be seeing the same thing? Either we're both losing our marbles or...
I'm
not. No. It's impossible.
Dear Zoe, this is now my third letter. I haven't heard back from you, so I hope you're getting them. I was thinking today about the last time I saw you. You were a little kid, clinging to your family. I was an 18-year-old, clinging to the idea of freedom. Your face when we took your dad away. It felt right to me, knowing you'd get clear of us. But in other ways, Nothing that day felt right. I know my family scarred you for life. They left their mark on me too. I wonder every day who I could have been if we hadn't robbed that house. There's a lot I want to say to you, Zoe. Things to ask, things to explain. About how we came to be at the motel that night. And what happened in the mountains a few days afterward. I'm sure you learned some of it as you got older. But there's other things I'm sure you don't know. Please write back, Zoe. I need to hear from you. Yours, Jay.
don't need to be. Really. Shapes. We don't get a lot of birds here, but it doesn't matter. It'll be over soon.
Look, Jay.
What's wrong?
I keep seeing your face. In my dreams, out on the streets, I know it can't really be you, but it feels like you. That's why I finally came. I had to see you. Otherwise, I just couldn't keep going.
Zoe, are you all right? I know I've been in here a long time, but I can still tell when someone's not okay.
Hate me after everything my family did to you.
My dad was killed. What you and your family did can never be forgiven.
I'm stuck behind this glass, ain't I?
You're stuck there because you
tell you I'm sorry, that I didn't know better. The fact is, I should have known better, but you know something? If you being there tomorrow will help you move on, and it might, then I want you there. Hell, it'll make it all mean something. Otherwise, it's just the goddamn end.
Just calm down. This is yourself. Okay, tell him if it happened. It's all too much.